Davenport here, Coach, like opened up with a statement whenever you want.
You know, before the game, the team kind of got together, and we had played really disjointed and sloppy in our last game, and we really wanted to put together an overall team effort and be really fluid, not be so disjointed. And the starters in the first half, they were 80% efficient, and I got that stat at halftime, and that was just beautiful. I mean, they really took care of business, and that's why they're starters. I mean, they're efficient, they know the plays, they know the scout, and they have a very business-like mentality, so I thought they set the tone without any question, and our assist numbers were awesome tonight, and that made me really happy too. So our assist to turnover ratio was great, and it was almost 3-1, and that's the kind of team we need to be. So I thought UMass Lowell played very, very hard. They beat us on the glass. They really crashed, and we got runouts because of it, but I thought they gave us a nice lesson there. But, you know, happy with the field goal percentage and the overall just sharing the basketball. I think 66% of our field goals were assisted, and that's a big goal for us. And we've been hitting that this year with this team, and that's what makes us special.
Any questions?
Talk about the defense. You guys seem to be pretty consistent on the defensive side of the ball.
Yeah. We decided to give, you know, each assistant coach has a category they're responsible for, offense, defense, and kind of rebounding. And each assistant was able to give a non-negotiable, meaning if I see this action, if you're not doing this, you'll be out, and we'll cycle the entire lineup through before you get back in. I thought that was really good. The players took it seriously. So defensively, we wanted to make sure we always had ball pressure, because we've seen on film that when we don't have ball pressure, we're getting beat, and we're getting beat behind it. And it's not the person's fault. I mean, it's not the person's fault behind it. It's actually the person on the ball needed to just heat it up a little bit more. I thought we had great energy and great effort on the ball tonight. So that was one of those non-negotiables that they took very seriously.
Coach Erykah, what does being to know mean to you guys?
It's an honor. I just feel like we work so hard, so we've earned it. And coming in into the tournament, playing Baylor and Indiana, those are going to be really tough games for us. So this is just going to fuel us even more to hold our record and just play the best we can play.
Coach, can you touch on Baylor and Indiana coming up in the tournament?
Yeah, you know, we need a little bit of a break. You know, we got a little sloppy there. After the way we played today, though, I kind of wish we didn't have the break, because I liked our rhythm today. But some bad habits just kind of crept up, and the free throw line. I mean, we can't give those points to either any of the teams on the remaining of our schedule. We can't give 8 points back. We can't miss 14 three-pointers and really win the high-level games that we need to win. And when we needed to make shots against the tougher teams in our non-conference, we made them. But we're going to need to make them for 40 minutes, so we'll definitely work on that. And some of it's not just the shooter, it's the timing, it's the flow. And, you know, we got plenty of time to work on those couple things. But I'm going to give the kids a couple days off. They got more stuff due this week than they do during finals. It's just that kind of pre-finals crush. So, and they don't want to see me for a couple days anyway. We're good there.
Coach, clearly your team never gives up in the games that mm-hmm. you see. Their effort is always high. What
right.
do you say about your team?
Well, it's kind of a culture. I mean, I did look across and I saw Morgan Strowman sitting across, you know, right before the game. And she's one of those players that came here and set the standard. And nobody ever outworked Morgan Strowman. And I kind of wanted my team to play hard for her so that she could see the legacy that she left. I mean, Stroh was always on the ground. She was always diving on board. She was always rebounding. She was always running. And I thought Erykah, it was a Strowman-like effort tonight, the way she ran that floor. And it's just one of those things where when you're building a program and one of your alum returns, you honor them with how you play. And I thought they honored her.
Anything else?
Erykah, how did you feel you played overall tonight? And how's that going to translate into after you have this time off going in
the day? Every game going in, my goal is just be efficient. It's not to have the most points, have the most rebounds. I just want to be efficient and do what Erykah is supposed to do to make my team better. So I felt like I did that tonight, and going in, I just want to keep it going.
Anything else? Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.